fools! Mercer's been here. I hope we aren't too late. Brynjolf and I found them like that. Mercer's doing. We have to catch up to him before it's too late. We should tread carefully. I wouldn't be surprised if he's left behind a few surprises for us.
Ugh. Do the Falmer also have no sense of smell? This place reeks.
Keep as quiet as you can. The Falmer may be blind, but they can still hear us.
size of this place. Have you ever seen anything like it in your life, lass?
Can't say that I have. Imagine the riches hidden within these walls.
To the pain, then. take the low road or the high road across this chamber. Your choice.
Wait. I hear something.
this is what...
Need to block pursuit. It must be... Mercer. We'll have to find another way around.
Mercer was able to knock this thing. Look at that monstrosity.
It's a dwarven centurion. For a tunnel, it's very deadly.
We can take the beast on. It's your call, lass. We're right behind you.
assholes!
This is where we saw Mercer. We must be getting close.
Crime is one thing. Murder is another. Mercer will answer for this. The stench. This place reeks of Falmer.
This is where
I'm death from the sun.
Even a farmer don't deserve the pain these implements must have inflicted. Those were a cruel ride. sneak through or take them down. I don't care. As long as we get to Mercer.
Aye. Whatever you want to do, we're with you.
best prepare ourselves. He's here, and he hasn't seen us yet. Brynjolf, watch the door.
Eyelass, nothing's getting by me.
Climb down that ledge. See if you can...
Carlia, when will you learn you can't get the drop on me? When Brynjolf brought you before me, I could feel a sudden shift in the wind. And at that moment, I knew it would end with one of us at the end of a blade. What's Carlia been filling your head with? Tales of thieves with honor, oaths ripe with falsehoods and broken promises. Nocturnal doesn't care about you, the key, or anything having to do with the guild. Wait a moment. Do I detect a hint of genuine avarice from this noble thief? Perhaps Carlia and Brynjolf misjudged you, and your true nature is no different than my own. Clear, you'll never see the skeleton key as I do, as an instrument of limitless wealth. Instead, you've chosen to fall over your own foolish code. Then the die is cast, and once again my blade will taste Nightingale blood.
And the eye.
Sorry, lass. I've got important things to do. We'll speak another time. Sorry, lass. I've got important things to do.
I can't believe it's over.
We'll speak another time.
25 years in exile, just like that. It's done. All that remains is to ensure the safe return of the skeleton key. I'm afraid it's not that simple. When the skeleton key was stolen from the Twilight Sepulchre, our access to the inner sanctum was removed. The only way to bring it back will be through the Pilgrim's Path. It wasn't created for the Nightingales. It was created to test those who wish to serve Nocturnal in other ways. As a consequence, I have no knowledge of what you'll be facing. Brynjolf is needed back at the Thieves Guild to keep order while you're away. And I can't bear to face Nocturnal after my failure to protect the key. I'm afraid you'll have to face the end of your journey alone. Take this with you. I'm not certain if it will help within the walls of the Sepulchre, but I certainly don't need it as much as you. I've had this bow almost my entire life, and it's never let me down. I hope it brings you the same luck. Even though Nocturnal doesn't desire worship in the traditional sense, the Twilight Sepulchre propagated a small group of priests. Of course, they never come into direct contact with Nocturnal, but they insisted they had her favor. As part of their duties, the priests created all sorts of baseless rituals and ceremonies, all on Nocturnal's behalf. These priests weren't a threat to the Skeleton Key, or the conduit to Nocturnal's realm, so they were tolerated. One of their ceremonies involved the Pilgrim's Path, a so-called test of worthiness. If a pilgrim was able to complete the path, it was said that they would live forever in Twilight. What that means is anyone's guess. The conduit to Nocturnal's realm, the realm of Everglow, has been in Skyrim, well, longer than recorded history. The Twilight Sepulchre was constructed around it by Man and Myr in order to shield it from those who would exploit its power. It's through this conduit that we're given Nocturnal's greatest gift, our luck. What she gains in return is a complete mystery. The agent of subterfuge utilizes shadow to cloud the judgment of those around him. By weaving the darkness to their will, this agent can manipulate others into fighting for the Nightingale for a limited time. This agent of strife can send forth a tendril of pure darkness into the heart of another, causing great injury to them. At the same time, this tether will bolster the agent's own life force, making him stronger. The agent of stealth is the master of remaining unseen. They are able to manipulate the darkness and use it to their advantage. On moonlit nights or in darkened rooms, this agent literally becomes invisible.
Sorry, lass. I've got important things to do. We'll speak another time.
Careful with that fire.
What can I do for you, friend?
Hello. My name is Auriella, the bard that you asked your steward to hire. I hope my music will be pleasing to you. Certainly. I am trained at the most elegant of instruments. The pinnacle of the bardic art.
Where do you want to go?
And back, and we'll be off.
Oh, there once was a hero named Ragnar, the red who came riding to right run from all Rorik's day.
Me guess. Someone stole your sweet roll.
Oh, what happened?
Welcome. Let me know if you want anything. I think I got a clean mug around here. Somewhere.
You're going to have the men around here.
Welcome to Dead Man's Drink.
In no time.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.